Good morning, family. Welcome back. I recently emptied out my medicine cabinet and decided I really need to go through it, clean out, and stock up. Because of a recent trip to Walmart, and I'll share a video of what the aisles look like. This was on a Monday, and then I went back on a Thursday, and it was the same thing. So a lot of stock is missing, and I'm not sure what's going on or why that's happening. But I thought I better get my medicine cabinet stocked with what I can find. So I pulled everything out of my medicine cabinet and spread it out on the counter. And I've got all my pain meds, over-the-counter pain meds like Tylenol, ibuprofen, naproxen, aspirin, and threw out what was out of date. And then I decided what I needed to stock up on. I'm pretty well stocked on over-the-counter pain relievers. I needed some more anti-diarrheal medicine, and you can see in the video all the different things that I have. It is very important to have anti-diarrhea medicine, because if you get a stomach virus and you get dehydrated, you could end up having a stroke. So I keep that. I keep antacids. Benadryl, absolutely a must. I got into a fire ant bed. My husband ran over a hornet's nest, so I restocked up on the Benadryl because we use that up. Cough medicines, flu and cold. And of course, I picked up some good herbal cough drops to help with sore throats. I've got a good selection of vitamins, but I have a huge order that's coming in, and I'll go over that in another video. But I really feel like vitamins are important to keep your immune system strong. So I guess the main important things are like your Benadryl, your pain reliever, diarrhea medicine. And as I went through, I kind of made a list of the things I did not have, so that when I go shopping, I can try to find those things. One of them was some Pepto-Bismol. That's always good. Covers a lot of issues, headache, stomach, diarrhea. So I wanted to get some Pepto-Bismol. Some of us ladies are prone to cystitis, and if you can't get some relief from that, you're in a mess. So I bought some Systex tablets, put that on my list to buy, so that I could have them in case I can't get through to the doctor. I needed some extra cough syrup. The last couple of times we've had a bad cough, we really needed the cough syrup, and actually Walmart did not have any in stock. So I've got a recipe at the end of this video that I'll share with you, a homemade cough syrup that's really good. So I'll share that with you towards the end of the video. So I went back to Walmart today, and I picked up what I needed, some cold and flu meds, which is great if you're feeling horrible and you just want to feel a little bit better, or you want to sleep good, that's perfect. I got some like Afrin type nasal mist, some medication for high blood pressure, and then this is the urinary pain relief tablets that you should always have in your pantry if you're prone to that. Picked up some coconut oil and baking soda. And I'm going to do some future videos on how to use baking soda. There's so many different ways you can use that with coconut oil, and I'll share that. And I'm also going to share a video on all the ways you can use Vicks Vapor Rub. Now, that little tiny jar of Vicks Vapor Rub is $7.28 now. It has skyrocketed in price. But the Walmart brand was $1.98, and I've never tried that before, so I'm kind of anxious to see how it does. But I grew up with Vicks Vapor Rub, and I highly believe in it. So, and I'll share some recipes on how to make some shower melts to steam in your shower with the Vapor Rub and the baking soda. Now, if you have someone in your family that's come home with a stomach virus, you have everybody else drink 100% grape juice, and that usually always stops it from spreading. Pineapple juice is great for coughs, for children. And then this is my recipe. Anytime I feel like I'm getting a sore throat or a cold, I will mix these items up and make me a hot tea and drink it 3 or 4 times a day. It usually fights off whatever infection I'm getting. Now, I've picked up these little composition books at Walmart. They're 50 cents a piece now. And so I'm writing down all of my herbal remedies in this one. because if the internet goes out, I will still have it written down. And I think that's a good idea. I'm going to make one for bread recipes and different things, but this is my health one that I'm going to start putting all my recipes in. So this recipe is, it's strong, but it works. It's 2 tablespoons of a really good apple cider vinegar, and I use Bragg's, 2 tablespoons of lemon juice, and I already have 8 ounces of hot water in the cup, and then 2 tablespoons of raw honey. And if you can purchase that from someone local, that's even better. I am at this time looking for some local honey that I can purchase and stock up my pantry. And then you're going to sprinkle in some cinnamon. Cinnamon is great for fighting bacterial infections. Honey soothes the throat. Lemon juice and apple cider vinegar will cut the sinus mucus. So this is a great tea, and I always make it the first time I feel like I'm getting a cold or sore throat, and it really, really helps. So these are items that you would can stock your pantry with to have and make you a nice hot tea. Now, some people add a little bit of whiskey to that if you've got a really bad cough. I don't do that, but I could see if you're really sick and you can't sleep, you might want to add a tablespoon of whiskey to that. But anyway, the water's been really hot. I stir it up, dissolve that honey, and then take some sips. And it's strong, but it's good. It works. Just a few sips and you can already feel it going down your throat. It unclogs all that sinus. And it's just a great remedy. I'll leave that recipe below. And also, I'll leave a list of items that you could pick up to get your pantry stocked. So thanks so much for watching. I hope this helps someone else get their medicine cabinet all stocked up for whatever comes. Thank you so much. Have a very blessed day and be safe.